Greetings and prayerful wishes. Welcome to Psycho Spiritual Awakening Meditation. Today, we are going to reflect on different types of sins and the ways and means to come out of the sins. How is sin divided? Sin is divided into the sin we inherit called original sin and the sin we commit ourselves called actual sin. Actual sin is subdivided into greater sins called mortal and lesser sins called venial. How many ways may actual sin be committed? Actual sin may be committed in two ways, namely by willfully doing things forbidden or by willfully neglecting things commanded. What is our sins called when we neglect things commanded? When we neglect things commanded, our sin is called a sin of omission. Such sins as willfully neglecting to participate in the Mass on Sunday or neglecting to go to confession at least once a year are sins of omission. Is original sin the only kind of sin? Original sin is not the only kind of sin. There is another kind of sin which we commit ourselves called actual sin. What is actual sin? Actual sin, any willful thought, word, deed or omission contrary to the law of God. How many kinds of actual sins are there? There are two kinds of actual sin, mortal and venial. What is mortal sin? A mortal sin is a grievous offense against the law of God. Why is this sin called mortal? This sin is called mortal because it deprives us of spiritual life, which is sanctifying grace, and brings everlasting death and damnation on the soul. How many things are necessary to make a sin mortal? To make a sin mortal, three things are necessary: a grievous matter, sufficient reflection, and full consent of the will. What do you mean by grievous matter with regard to sin? By grievous matter with regard to sin, we mean that the thought, word or deed by which mortal sin is committed must be either very bad in itself or severely prohibited and therefore sufficient to make mortal sin if deliberately yield to it. What does sufficient reflection and full consent of the will mean? Sufficient reflection means that we must know the thought, word or deed to be sinful at the same time we are guilty of it. And full consent of the will means that we must fully and willfully yield to it. What are sins committed without reflection or consent called? Sins committed without reflection or consent are called material sins. That is, they would be moral or real sins if we knew their influences and sinfulness at the time we committed them. Thus, to eat flesh meat on the day of abstinence without knowing it to be a day of abstinence or without thinking of the prohibition would be the material sin. Do past material sins become real sins as soon as we discover their sinfulness? Past material things do not become real sins as soon as we discover their sinfulness, unless we again repeat them with the full knowledge and consent. How do we know that what sins are considered mortal? We know what sins are considered mortal from Holy Scripture, from the teaching of the Church, and from the writings of the fathers and doctors of the Church. Why is it wrong to judge others guilty to sin? It is wrong to judge others guilty to sin because we cannot know for certain their sinful act was committed with sufficient reflection and full consent of the will. What sin does he commit who without sufficient reason believes another guilty of sin? he or she who, without sufficient reason, believes another guilty of sin, commits a sin of rash judgment. What is venial sin? Venial sin is a slight offense against the law of God in matters of less importance or in matters of great importance. It is an offense committed without sufficient reflection or full consent of the will. Can we always distinguish venial from mortal sin? We cannot always distinguish venial sin from mortal sin, and in such cases we must leave the decision to our confessor. Can slight offenses ever become mortal sins? Slight offenses can become mortal sins if we commit them through defiant contempt for God and His law, and also when they are followed by very evil consequences which we foresee in committing them. Dear ones, let's reflect the type, kinds of sins we commit and how often we commit these type of sins. Let's reflect over it and come out of it to have a joyful, peaceful and healthy living. May God bless you. Inspiration ripples. Thank you very much.
மெய்ப்பணும் செய்தி நிறைவாக்கும் இறைவாக்கும்.